Have you ever tried learning to code, but found yourself stalling, quitting, or just staring at the screen thinking, I have no idea what I'm doing? I've been there. In this video, I'll show you 8 beginner mistakes to avoid and a simple 30-minute plan you can start tonight. Mistake number 3, that's the one that ends tutorial hell, so at least stay for that one. If we haven't met, I'm Pete and I've been coding professionally since 2012. And my job here is to help beginners get unstuck and finally make it as developers. Mistake number 1, only watching tutorials. Be honest, have you ever watched hours of tutorials, felt productive, but at the end of the week realized you hadn't actually built anything? I used to do this all the time. I would binge videos late at night, feel like I was absorbing knowledge, and then nothing. Next day, I couldn't remember half of it. That's like watching cooking shows and never turning on the stove. You can explain a recipe to your friends, but dinner still isn't getting made and you're still ordering KFC. The fix? For every 20 to 30 minutes you watch, spend an hour building. The same day. Close the video, try it from memory. When you get stuck, Google the exact question or ask GPT. How do I loop until X? How do I read input? That's how real developers learn, even after years. Keep it tiny. One button, one loop, one file, one feature. Small and ugly will teach you more than polished and incomplete, believe me. When I built my first JavaScript application, it was literally a button that counted clicks. It was hideous, but pressing that button and watching the numbers go up gave me more confidence than 10 hours of watching someone else build something. Your move tonight, watch 10 minutes, build 40, ship something tiny. Mistake number 2, learning 5 things at once. When I started, I wanted to learn everything. React, Tailwind, TypeScript, APIs, Git. My browser had so many tabs open, I thought it might explode, literally. And guess what? I didn't master any of it. That's like trying to learn guitar, piano, and drums all at once. You make noise, not music. The fix? One skill, one tiny project, then repeat. For example, for web development, learn a bit of JavaScript. Build a tip splitter, which is bill divided by people plus the tip percentage. For Python, learn loops, build a number guess game. For game development, learn movement, build a coin pickup. One brick at a time. Stack them and you've got a wall. Scatter them and you've just got Lego pieces all over the floor. Don't step on them. By the way, I put together a free roadmap for web, Python, and game development with more of these tiny project ideas. Links below if you want it. Mistake number 3. No weekly plan. This was me for months. I was learning, but all I had was a folder of random snippets and half-finished projects. That's like going to the gym once a month, lifting for 2 hours, and wondering why you're not in shape. Well, guess why not? You need a simple, repeatable routine. The fix? The 5-day plan, 30 minutes a day. Day 1, learn one concept, build something tiny the same day. Day 2, read your code, write 5 notes about what you've learned. Day 3, add 1 improvement. Day 4, share it, push it to GitHub, or record a 60-second demo. Day 5, preview a new concept and plan the next build. It's like practicing music. Learn a chord, play a simple song, tweak it, show a friend, then learn the next chord. When I finally started doing this, my progress shot up. Instead of a messy pile of tutorials, I had a trail of projects, small, yes, but real. And that made me actually feel like a developer. Your move this week? Put 5 30-minute sessions in your calendar and treat them like appointments. If you don't have a calendar, don't worry. Just go make one. Mistake number 4. Copy-pasting fixes you don't understand. Raise your hand if you've pasted an answer you found online without even reading it fully. Yeah, me too. At first I thought that was fine. Hey, it works. But then the same bug came back, slightly different, and then I was stuck again. That's like copying a recipe without tasting as you go. Sure, it might come out okay once, but the moment you swap an ingredient, you're lost. The fix? The 3-step debug. 1. Read the error in plain English. 2. Ask, what changed right before this broke? 3. Reproduce it in the smallest possible file. Most errors fall into a few categories. Missing thing, wrong type, wrong order, wrong target. Learn to spot those patterns and suddenly debugging feel less like a panic attack and more like a detective work. Your move today, next time you fix a bug, write one line in your notes. Bug, cause, fix. Trust me, this tiny habit will save you months. Mistake number 5, skipping Git and GitHub. I avoided Git for way too long. Honestly, I was scared of it. I thought it was only for real developers. So I coded quietly on my laptop for months. And at the end, I had nothing to show. That's like playing songs in your room, but never hitting record. No proof you're improving. The fix? Start a daily push streak. Even one line counts, believe me. It's your training log, it's your portfolio timeline, and it makes Git less scary because it becomes a habit. Your move today. Make a repository called Tiny Wins. Push one change, tomorrow push another, and it's like you just pressed record on your journey. Congratulations, my dear legend. Mistake number 6, hiding stupid questions. When I started, I was terrified of asking dumb questions. Everyone online seemed so smart that I didn't want to expose myself. So I stayed silent and I stayed stuck. That's like trying to learn an instrument but never asking how to tune it. You will keep fighting the instrument instead of playing music. The fix? Ask early, ask clearly. So, with AI you can try. Explain this like I'm 12. Give me one example, quiz me with one question. With humans, give one sentence of context and your best guess. The truth? Every dumb question I asked turned out to be one that dozens of other beginners were too scared to ask. So, your move? Ask one dumb question today in the comments below. That's how you move faster. Mistake number 7. Chasing perfect code before done. I once spent 3 hours trying to name a variable, just staring at the screen. Spoiler, the project never, ever, ever shipped. Perfection is a trap. It's like reorganizing the kitchen before you've even cooked. It feels productive, but nobody ate. The fix? Ship ugly, polish later. Today, make it work. Tomorrow, clean it up. On the weekend, add a test. So your move? Finish one feature today, even if the code is a mess. Mistake number 8, going solo. When nobody knows you're coding, quitting is easy. I've done it more than once, believe me. That's like training for a marathon without telling anyone. The first rainy day, you're out. The fix? Create a 30-minute ritual and make it public. Same time, same place, one small task. Then join my Discord server and post in the relevant channel day 1. Today I did X. That small bit of accountability is often the difference between quitting and finally making it. Your move? Start your streak today. Go post day 1. If you want this whole system written down with tiny project ideas for web, Python, and game development, I put it all together in a free roadmap. Link in the description below. And if you want me to walk you through each path step by step, I made a full roadmaps video where I break down exactly what to learn in what order. I will link that at the end screen and down below too. If you need a structured start, try Scrimba. You can start completely free, and if you ever decide to upgrade, you will get 20% off with my link in the description below. It's hands-on, beginner-friendly, and honestly one of the best platforms to practice without feeling overwhelmed. So, quick recap. 5 minutes, pick your path. 20 minutes, build the tiniest thing you can. 5 minutes, push it to GitHub, and write one sentence about what you learned. Then comment day 1 with your task. I will be checking the comments and cheering you on. Quick recap. Don't just watch, build. One skill, one project. Follow the 5-day plan. Debug in 3 steps. Push daily. Ask early, ship ugly, and don't go solo. If this helped, give it a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and go watch my roadmaps video next. It breaks down each path in detail so you know exactly what to learn in what order. Thanks for watching, you legends. I'm Pete, and I'll see you on the next one.